Hello everyone, I am Nisha from IIMT Group of Colleges. I am here to discuss the topic Android Operating System. There are several things to cover in this session. I will cover introduction to Android, Android features, components of Android, architecture and difference between the iOS and Android. Introduction to Android. What is Android? Basically, Android is an operating system designed for mobile devices. Mobile devices means your mobile phones, tabs, etc. In 2005, Google purchased Android, and after working with Android with OHA group, that is Open Handset Alliance group, in 2008 Google introduced Android in the market. Before that, in 2007, iOS was running in the market. iOS was the product of Apple. Still it is working in the market. iOS was product of Apple. Nokia was product of Symbian. But we can say Android is not direct product of any company. Android was developed by OHA group. In the OHA group, there are 84 companies, 84 to 87 companies are working together. All the companies are providing different features to the operating system, for their hardware, for their networking, and for their operating system as well. Day by day, Android expanding in the market with several applications. In each and every year, Android is giving different versions. The Android started its version from Android 1.1. After that, different versions was released. In the first version was its cupcake. And after that, the sequence, Android managed the sequence like alphabetically it has introduced the different versions, like C for cupcake. After that, donut was introduced. After that, eclairs, and so on. The latest version of Android, Pi. Android Pi was released on 6th August 2018. This is the latest version of Pi. And in each and every version of Android, there are several features added by the OHA group. Initially, there are several bugs with the operating system, but day by day, bugs are reducing. But still, one problem is associated with the system, that is problem of security. We can say, till now, Apple is providing its operating system, that is iOS, which is more secure than Android. Why? Android is a open source. This is the advantage as well as disadvantage of Android. Advantage, because a developer is very much enriched with the code. He or she have already platform to work. They are not supposed to start with the zero level. But it is also a disadvantage because of open source, it is insecure. Still, Android is not secure. That's why the big organization which are focused on only security like defense and all, they are not using Android till now. Focusing on features of Android, there are several features. First one is open source. Second is DVM. Third is attractive. Layouts. Fourth is lots of applications available. Fifth is easy, etc. Focusing on open source, as Android uses Linux kernel for working on the platform, that's why Android is also an open source application platform for the the application which we run on. There are two types of thing associated with an operating system, that is application software and the system software. Here iOS is using Linux kernel. Linux kernel is itself a open source. Talking about DVM, that is Dalvik Virtual Machine. As Android work on Java, there is a high requirement of JVM. JVM is used for executing bytecodes on the machine, but JVM converts the bytecode which work on the machine are of very heavy weight. That's why DVM was introduced. DVM executes very lightweight programs. Apart from that, DVM also uses SQLite. SQLite server. SQLite server is used for storing all the data associated with all the applications and resources. After that, focusing on attractive layout. Android is a very attractive, all the pages and applications that we use are very much attractive just because of frameworks. Frameworks are provided already in Android layout. A developer is very much enriched with all the codes and free to work with different pages and all. After that, lots of applications available. As OHA work is working together, there are several minds associated with Android. That's why day by day, thousands of applications are introduced and till now lakhs of applications are available in the market. We have to simply install all the applications through Play Store. Easy. We can say Android is very easy. Easy means comfortable to use. We maximum people are here Android users because it's very easy to work with the Android operating system for a developer, for a layman too. A 3-year-old kid and a old person too are very much comfortable with the mobile phone associated with Android applications. Because its graphical user interface is very much attractive and easy to work with. All the codes available in Android are not headache of a developer. Developer are already having frameworks of Java and different languages. Android also uses a native library of different languages. For graphical user interfaces, OpenGL's library are also available. That's why we, you and I, even anyone can be Android developer and can work for developing applications. Apart from security issue, there is no issue in Android operating system. Only security is still concerned. Security is still area of our concern. Now we will discuss components of Android. Very first is activity. Second is services. Third is broadcast, receiver, and the last is content provider. There are four components of Android. First one is activity. Focusing on activity. Activity is all the running processes, all the pages we open next by next, all our activities. All running processes are activities in Android. Second, services. All the background running activities are known as services. For example, you have connected your phone with the Wi-Fi, or you have played several songs with your media player. There is no need of user interaction with the mobile phone, still activity will run. That's why this is known as services. Third is broadcast receiver. Whenever your phone is connected with your charger, you got an icon on your screen, or you connect your earphone with the charger, you get a icon on your screen. This is all because of broadcast receiver. This is the system management of Android to publish whatever it receive in the form of hardware on the screen of the user. And the last one is content provider. As Android is an operating system, definitely resource providing management must be concerned with the Linux. Linux provide different resources as per the requirement. Suppose we want to exchange data between two different nodes. Nodes are here your application, nodes are here your mobile phones. If one node is here and second node is here, then definitely for data exchange, a manager will be required. Here, the Linux kernel is responsible for providing resources and freeing of resources. Our next topic is Android architecture. As I have discussed earlier, Android is based on Linux kernel. So the basic layer of Android composes with Linux. And for an operating system, its responsibilities will be resource management, power management, before that there is a layer of native libraries and DVM along with core libraries. Upon that, frameworks of Android and on the top level all the applications with which we interact are associated. This is the architecture of Android. We will discuss this architecture in my next video. Thank you.